Now here's some troubleshooting tips about working with interfaces that you can do either before you install an interface or if you're having trouble. First thing I'm going to do is open up a command window and simply see if I can use the ping utility. This is a general networking utility you can use to check connectivity between this interface node and the home node, the Pi server. I just pinged my OSIsoft training. That's my Pi server. If I can't do that, no point in going any further. So what's the next step? Well, the next step is there's a nice little utility you'll find under Program Files PIPC in the bin directory. Now, you're going to have different directories in this PIPC directory depending on what you've installed. Because I've already installed my Pi SDK, I have a bin directory. It stands for binaries. If I change directories to there, you'll find a little utility called APISnap. APISnap allows you to check to see if the normal, what we call our API low-level, DLL, the API subroutines, can connect from the interface node to the Pi server. So APISnap, and then the name of the server, and that should go ahead and connect. Now, take a look. It just says enter tag name. Actually, I don't have to go any further. I know from experience that means it's connected to the server. If you want, you can take a look at the value of a Pi tag. It just shows you what the current value is. Now, next up would be to use this About Pi SDK. Now, if you go into the PIPC/SDK directory, or Pi SDK, you'll see this About Pi SDK. You can run this, do a connection to see if you're connecting with the SDK, with the software development kit. Anyway, just click on the name of the server right here in this checkbox. That will attempt to do a connect. When that connects properly, then you know you've got good connectivity for what you need. Now, this doesn't mean that we've got the privileges that we're going to need, the actual security we're going to need. This just indicates the connections appear to be working. Now, one of the nice troubleshooting tools you have is you can look in the message log that's stored on the local, this interface node. You'll find that under the PIPC directory in the DAT subdirectory. It's called PIPC.log. Let me just sort these by date. Yeah, there it is. And as you can see, here are the indications that this is my API-based applications are connecting. Now, as you can see, I'm getting this APISnap is executing a connection, and this looks like it did that connection properly. Now this PIPC.log is where the messages for the API-based applications are written. If you go back into the Pi server, you'll find under the System Manager message log those messages written by the SDK. So if I go into Operation and then Message Logs, if we do a search for the most recent messages, you'll see the connections that have just been made from the, from the remote machines. Here's the message from my interface node. I can see the IP address right there. Anyway, so those are where you'd find the SDK-based messages. Well, finally, no matter which message logs you're looking for or you're looking at, you may find you see some error messages that that you can look up on our website. So if you go into the tech support website under the Knowledge Center, there's an option there called Search Support. Very common error message is this -10401. So as you can see, I've entered this with double quotes and then put in the negative sign. This is going to go tell me what that, or find all those calls and help me translate what that error message is. There we go. So in this case, we found some search results that document what that error message means.